everyone, I'm Maddie for Ready, Set, Do, and today I'm going to show you how I do my stage makeup. I've been an actor and performer since I was 3 years old, so I definitely have my favorite tips and tricks down to getting a perfect and flawless makeup application for the stage. Okay, so now that I look completely different, what you'll need for stage makeup is basically everything that you would use with your normal day-to-day makeup. So foundation, concealer, powder, eyeshadow, blush, lipstick. It's just a matter of how much we're putting on and kind of. So you'll need foundation, concealer, a translucent powder or a pressed powder, it doesn't really matter, bronzer, blush, eyeliner, mascara, some fake eyelashes, and some eyelash glue, lipstick, and an eyeshadow palette, or just any eyeshadow that you have. Those are the basics that you need. You can always add some more stuff on that I'll kind of show later, but that is bare minimum what you'll need for stage makeup. So you're gonna wanna start with a clean, moisturized face. You can use a primer. Honestly, I don't use a primer every single time. I don't find it makes the biggest difference, but if you wanna use a primer, you definitely can. And the first thing I'm gonna do is take my foundation. You can use any foundation that you like. I recommend something that's full coverage just because on the stage, you want it to be heavy. Mainly because the lights really, really wash you out. If you go on stage with no makeup on, you will look like a ghost because the lights are so bright and they will wash you out an insane amount. So with stage makeup, honestly, the more the better. I know the saying in makeup is less is more, not the case with stage makeup. So I just use a brush and I paint this all over my face and down my neck because you don't want your face and neck to be two different colors. Now that I've painted that all over my face, I'm going to use a wet beauty blender and just kind of blend it all in so there's no like paintbrush strokes on my face. All right, now that that is blended in, we're going to take our concealer. You can use any concealer. Again, I recommend something a little bit more full coverage, but if it's not full coverage, you can always layer and build it up. But we're just going to put that under our eyes to cover up those dark circles. I also like to put this on my eyelids to act as an eyeshadow primer. And then you're just gonna put this on any blemishes you have. So I have one right there. I like to put it around my nose to get the redness out. And we're going to use, you can use a brush, but I like to use a wet beauty blender to blend this all in. Now that that's blended, I like to go in with a translucent powder. It does not have to be translucent. This is just what I like to do. So I take the Laura Mercier translucent powder, which is my favorite, and I pour some of it onto the lid, and I take a little brush, and I just put that underneath my eyes and on my eyelid. So basically anywhere I put the concealer, I'll put the translucent powder on top. And this will just help it to not crease, not sweat right off your face. You definitely need to set any cream product on your face with a powder, or else it's gonna go everywhere and it'll get on your costumes. It just won't be good. So definitely set it with powder. Now to set my face, I like to use a foundation powder just to give me some extra coverage. You don't have to use a foundation powder. You can use that translucent powder. You can use whatever powder you want. But I just like to apply this to my face all over and again down your neck so everything is the same color. Now that that we look one color, we need to add some definition and life back into our face, because if we were to go on stage like this, we would look scary. So the first step to adding life back into our face is using bronzer. This is a palette I have. I've had this forever. You don't have to have any sort of fancy bronzer. So I just kind of do this, and we're going to put this under our cheekbones and see how that already adds some color back into my face. I also like to put this around my forehead. And if you want, you can put it underneath your chin just for a little bit of definition. Again, more is more. You want to put this on pretty heavily just because the lights will, again, wash you out. And sometimes I like to put it down the sides of my nose just to add a little bit of color there too. Next, we're doing blush. Blush is a super, super important part of stage makeup. You are going to want to pack this on because this is what's really going to bring your face to life on stage. So I like to smile, or you don't have to smile, you can just do whatever, and really pack it on. See how much more alive we look? So now we look so much more alive, and the next step we have is eyebrows. Now, I didn't really start filling in my eyebrows until about senior year of high school when I was doing shows, and I look back at the shows where I didn't fill in my eyebrows, and you cannot even see them on stage. So I would recommend always filling in your eyebrows. Because that's how you express yourself, and if they can't see your eyebrows, it's a little bit weird. So I like to take an eyeshadow. I usually fill it in with a pencil from like day to day, but for the stage, I do like it to be a little bit darker. So I just take a dark brown eyeshadow that kind of matches my hair color, and I just kind of fill it all in, and it should look pretty intense, but again, that's what we're going for. Like, look at the difference. Wow. Awesome. And then to finish out the eyebrows, I like to set them with a gel. You definitely do not have to do this, but since my eyebrows are a little bit fuller and the hair a little bit long, I just like to put them in place. But again, nobody will know if you do this or not. It's just kind of something I like to do. Now for the fun part, we have the eyeshadow. So I have the Naked palette. I have used this forever. It's perfect for the stage because it has your lights all the way to your darks. And usually for the stage, I mean, depending on the show, I like to do a really dark, smoky eye. But again, I would ask your dance teacher or your director, what kind of the guidelines are for the eyeshadow, but most of the time you're going to do a smoky eye. So I like to start out by taking a little blending brush and just using a light brown color. This is gonna be your transition shade. So once you do the smoky eye, it's not as unblended. This is going to help kind of blend everything in. So I just like to apply that to my crease. And we'll go in later with a bit of a darker shade. Now I take a flat brush and I go in with the black. And I know that this can be a little bit scary, but again, with the stage, it does not have to be perfect. just because the lights, again, will take everything down a little bit and the audience is far away. So if you don't get this perfect, no worries, practice makes perfect. So you put this kind of on the outer corner of your eye. I'm gonna look over here in this mirror. And you're gonna bring that up pretty high. So when you open your eye, you can still see the black on top. And I know I look pretty crazy, but that's okay. We're gonna blend it all out. So I like to put that up here and kind of bring it in. Do you see how I'm kind of bringing that in? So it should look something like that. So let's do that to the other eye. Again, if it's not perfect, no worries. Great, so now that we have the black in our outer corner, I like to take this gunmetal color, that's actually what it's called gunmetal, just a silvery kind of black, and I like to put that all over my lid to just kind of blend that together. And remember that transition shade I was talking about? Now we're going to take that again, and I also like to take a little bit of a darker brown, and we're going to put that right above that black that we put on our outer corner. And it doesn't make a huge difference, but I just like to do this so it's not as harsh of a black line. And to finish out the eyeshadow, I like to take that black on a really skinny brush and put that on my lower lash line. Now, I would usually use eyeliner, but I have misplaced mine. So we're just gonna use eyeshadow instead. Okay, so the eyeshadow is done. Now we are moving on to eyeliner. So for the stage, I like to use a liquid eyeliner just because it goes on easier. It's easier to make a wing. You don't have to do winged eyeliner. It's just something that I kind of like to do. So I highly, highly recommend using a waterproof eyeliner because you will be sweating, you might cry, and you just don't want black eyeliner running down your face. So I just like to do kind of a thick line and bring that out into a wing. Again, you don't have to do a wing, just your personal preference. So there you can see I did a little wing. Does not have to be perfect, nobody will know. So give your eyeliner just a second to dry, and we're going to move on to the fake eyelashes. Super, super important step. If you don't do any of this, definitely do the fake eyelashes because your eyelashes will be absolutely invisible on stage. You'll be surprised at how much more dramatic your whole face looks, which is exactly what we're going for. So you can use whatever fake eyelashes you want. I got these in a pack for like $10 at Target. They do not have to be expensive. So what you're going to do, fake eyelashes definitely take practice. I know the first 5 times I tried to put them on my eyes, I pretty much glued my eyes shut. So it definitely takes practice, so don't get discouraged. You're just going to glue the strip of the lash. You don't need a ton of glue, but just make sure that it is fully coated. And you're actually gonna wait about 20 seconds for this to just get a little bit tacky so it's easier to put onto your eye. So I just kinda like to fan it like this. Make sure you have the right eye. I'm blowing it a little bit. There you go. So can you see the difference between this eye and this eye? It's pretty cool, right? Now onto the other eye. So just put that strip down. And wait for it to dry a little bit. So our fake eyelashes are on. We're going to give that glue just a little bit of time to set, but for now we're going to take our waterproof mascara. I cannot stress this enough. And we're going to put that on our bottom lashes and then on our top lashes to blend our normal lashes and our fake ones together. Does anybody else make a weird face when you're doing mascara, or is that just me? All right, our eyes are complete. That is the final eye look. And you can kind of take the liberty of changing up the colors or anything you want, but this is kind of the standard of what I like to do for the stage. Now we're moving on to lipstick and my all-time holy grail favorite lipstick for the stage that has never done me wrong. It is the Rimmel Provocalypse 16 Hour Kiss Proof Lip Color. It is the best. And the shade is Kiss Me, You Fool. It's a super pretty bright red color, and it is a two-step liquid lipstick. I'm telling you guys, it does not come off, and that is exactly what you want in a stage lipstick. So we're going to put that all over our lips. And what I like about this is that you don't need a lip liner. It's just kind of all in one. So fun, right? I love this color. And then it comes with a sealant kind of thing that you put on top of it, and it just keeps it there all day. It does not move. I love it. Okay, we are almost done. One of the last steps you're going to do is take a setting spray and you're going to spray your whole face. I like to spray it a lot so it looks like I just jumped in the pool. You don't have to do it that much. It's just kind of what I like to do. So close your eyes, make sure that your mascara and everything is dry before you do this, obviously. And you're just gonna spray your whole face. Good. Now, here is one of my favorite tricks that I've learned. While your face is still wet, you're going to take your highlight. Again, you don't have to use a highlight, but it's just something I like to do to add a little bit of sparkle. And take a brush, and while your face is still wet, you're going to put that on your cheekbones, and it's going to make you look super sparkly. Wow. So cool, right? I just put that on the tip of my nose, a little bit on my chin. And I also like to take a little flat eyeshadow brush and put that right underneath my eyebrow. Isn't that so pretty? And you can also do this while your face is dry and you haven't set it yet, but making it wet is what's really going to make it pop. This is probably my favorite part of the whole thing. It's so pretty. So just on any high points of your face, I like to put that. And sometimes I'll just blend it out a little bit more. Do. And this looks so pretty on stage when the light gets it and you have that little gleam. Oh, it's so pretty. So this is the completed stage makeup. I know it looks like a lot, but like I've told y'all, once you get on stage, it's going to look flawless and you will look absolutely beautiful. And once you keep practicing, I promise you can get this whole routine down in less than 10 minutes. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope this inspires you to try some new makeup tricks in your makeup application. You can find me on Instagram at Maddie_Raz, or you can check out my actor's website, which is MadelineRasmusson.com. Bye, guys!